Good morning, everybody. I want to welcome the Barry community back to our weekly school showcases. It's been over a month since we've done one. It's so good to be back. I'm here at Barrytown Middle and Elementary School with Jess and Orman, tech integrationist here at Barrytown. And you may recall about a year ago, we were here for the Hour of Code, both here in Barry City, and here we are again. This is an international project that's happening all around the world, and the Barry schools participate as well. What's going on here today?
So we are celebrating Hour of Code, basically letting students just play with robots. The robots were introduced into the classroom last week, and they've been given kind of the freedom to code them to do what they want them to do. Some students are coding them to play music. Some students are coding them to drive in a certain shape. Basically, it's a lot of trial and error. They have to figure out their mistakes and how to fix the code, and they're just having a lot of fun.
And we have a middle school music teacher, Ally Tarwater, here. We'll talk to her in a second. The kids were dying to show me and Josh how these robots work. What are they called again?
They're called Edison robots.
Edison robots. They're super fun, and you're about to get a good look at them, so let's go talk to the kids.
Great.
Thanks. Madison, you're doing a great job talking about how the Edison works. How does this guy operate?
So the way he operates is that, so with Sound Edison, you can actually program it to play actual notes. So like for an example, my program for how to play Ode to Joy. As you can see, I have the start block, which everybody needs. And then I have a wait until clap detected. So when I program it, I press start and I clap, and it should play it.
Let's try it.
Yeah, that's my problem part, the last part. I need to make it go faster, but I have the right head tones.
Here with Ms. Tarwater, middle school band teacher here at Barrytown, along with Kano and Tariq, and I'd love to hear what you guys are working on now.
So in band, we have our 5th, 6th grade band concert tomorrow afternoon during the school day and evening at 6 o'clock. And Kano and Tariq are, Kano plays percussion, Tariq plays bass clarinet, and we are learning a song called Mechanical Monsters. And in digital literacy, they are programming their Edison robot to play Mechanical Monsters.
I don't like how it's trying to
wait. Look at that.
Everybody, we're at the Spalding Educational Alternatives Program here, C, our alternative school as part of Spalding. And I'm with Angelique Fairbrother, the tech integrationist at Spalding, who has been working with students here at C during the Hour of Code Week. What's going on up here?
So we decided we wanted to give our students an opportunity to explore with Minecraft. We have high school students here, and we want these guys to be the ambassadors. We want them to be able to explore and learn what they're capable of, and then they can design these worlds that can then be used in Barrytown. In Barry City.
Really, really neat. We're with Damien and Eric here. Eric, I understand that you've been doing some of the work here. You want to just describe some of the things you've been doing?
A lot of the things is hard to describe. It's mostly about Minecraft is expansive, mm-hmm. and you're able to do a lot of things. Think of it like putty. It's flexible, it's stretchable, but there's always a limit.
Exactly right. And what these guys are going to be is ambassadors for the kids at Barry City and Barrytown and helping do this. This is great, you guys. We're going to head to Barry City next. Eric, thank you. We're going to head to Barry City next to see what work they're doing in a fourth grade classroom. So thanks, guys. Great to be up at C. Folks, we are now at Barry City Elementary Middle School in Roberta Melnick's class, Miss Roberta. And I'm with Mike Martin, the tech integrationist here at Barry City. So we've met with all three tech integrationists for all of our schools, which is so cool. Mike, what have the kids been working on today? During Hour of Code.
So this was an introductory lesson on blockly coding. And we take the approach here that we try to teach problem solving through coding. So it's just not about coding in the computers themselves. And so right now they are learning how to create code to make an angry bird catch some things in the maze.
And it was really neat because all the kids knew what angry birds were. So they could make the connection right out of the gate. And what we're seeing is connections. Mr. Allen noticed this as well, connections to what's going on at Barrytown, at sea as well, and what the Spalding kids are doing. It's all very similar, introducing this work to the kids. So thank you. It's really good to see. And a couple quick announcements before we go. First of all, we've really missed doing these showcases. They're going to start coming regularly. We hope you enjoyed this one. As we go into the holiday break, I want to remind families that we've had a lot of illness in our schools the last 2-3 weeks for both staff and kids, and not just the sniffles, but like serious flu-like symptoms, and it's keeping a lot of kids and staff out at Barrytown and Barry City. Recently, we've had over 200 students out a day. So the reason I mention this is in these last 4 or 5 days of school, it's important that if your child is sick or you are sick, please stay home. That is the safest thing you can do and the easiest way that we can make sure that we can keep schools open going into the holiday and beyond. So we need your cooperation with that. We really hope everybody's going to feel better going into the holiday break. And we thank you for watching today. Have a great rest of the week, and we'll be back in touch with you next week for our next showcase.